have been very critical of this president, but when you look at this situation as objectively as you can, I wonder if you felt like the president's words were strong enough.
Of course I didn't. Look, I don't like this president. Let me start with that. I do not like him. But when he does things well, I like to clap for him, and I like to say he does something well. Like when yesterday the White House put out a statement on Venezuela, I thought it was a good and strong statement. Now, this speech today was shameful. Here is the bottom line. This was not many sides. This is one side. It is white supremacists trying to instill terror in the streets of America. What I saw last night was a Ku Klux Klan march without the hoods. It was a bunch of, you know, white supremacists holding torches, chanting out against the Jewish religion, chanting out, you know, about white supremacy. And the president of the United States, because he does not want to antagonize anybody in his base, let us be clear, does not have the spine, does not have the courage, does not have the leadership to call this out by name. And Anna, that Anna, is shameful.
That was
Ben, let me tell you something. He's a lot more capable of calling out his own attorney general. He's a lot more capable. In the last 24 hours, he has been calling out Mitch McConnell. But he doesn't have the spine or the guts to call out white supremacists committing domestic terrorism in America today. And I am not going to defend that. I don't care what party
he is. I didn't ask you to defend that. I asked you one question. Should the person who is driving the car into the crowd killing people or attempting to kill people, should that person also be condemned?
Absolutely. And he didn't
okay,
do it.
Okay, then
he
that would talk. Be considering
he started,
both sides.
Ben, he started talking
Ben,
about,
Ben,
he started
that,
talking
hold on,
about
Anna.
Trade
hold on, Anna. Let me just make sure the facts are out there.
Not,
Anna, hold
not
on.
What happened with the plowing of the car.
Hold on. Hold on. Regarding that car event, we are still waiting to find out exactly who may be under arrest in that incident, exactly who
sure.
the victims were. But we do know that the crowd of people who were plowed into were the counter-protesters, the people who had come to speak out against the white supremacists who were holding
That's
this rally.
That's what I'm saying. Both sides today, the person who was driving the car should be condemned. The other people that were involved in the violence as well. Both sides today became violent. We see it
no,
on the video.
That's not true.
You
no,
no,
side
no, that's
no.
the issue here.
We don't know that they were on different sides. No, but
go
listen,
ahead.
It is so, you can't say that this is both sides of violence. What we saw was white supremacists, and then what we saw were some brave people risking their lives and putting themselves in between white supremacists and that, you know, and what they were doing. So we saw white supremacists initiate this action, try to bully those people, try to instill fear, and we saw brave people there in Charlottesville standing against them. That is, you cannot equate both sides. This was not many sides. Today, it was not many sides. Today, it was white supremacists. And what the president of the United States said by trying to deflated as many sides, what he's trying to do is send a dog whistle to his base,
no,
to his supporters,
not true.
That
that's
some of whom were in that.
Ben, I'll give you the last word, and then we got to get a quick break, guys. Let me let Ben react with us.
Where the politics of this has gotten to the point where it's disgusting. The people's hatred of the president, some people's hatred of the president has gotten to the point where they want to turn everything into the worst case scenario instead of looking at what the president actually said. Go look at what he said when he condemned the attack today. Let me finish. Go look at the words of what the president said when he condemned it today and tell me that it wasn't very clear that he was condemning the violence of the white supremacists.
It was not clear. It would have been clear if he had said white supremacists. He didn't. It was not clear.
Okay.
It might have been clear.
Leave it there.
It wasn't clear.
Got to get in a quick.